We'll cover plenty of examples going from the compound name to the chemical formula and from the chemical formula to the compound name, because naming compounds doesn't have to be complicated. Hello everyone, I'm Melissa Maribel, your personal tutor, and before we get to the examples, here are three things you really need to know for naming compounds with polyatomic ions. Important thing one, to name an ionic compound with a polyatomic ion, the name will consist of the name of the metal followed by the name of the polyatomic ion, and everything is in lowercase. Important thing two, when finding the chemical formula from the compound name, we will always have to balance out the charges for ionic compounds. And these are the charges you will need to have memorized. So if you have to pause the video and write these down, please do so. Important thing three. Now, polyatomic ions, polyatomic meaning it's composed of two or more atoms, an ion meaning it has an overall charge. Here's a list of common polyatomic ions you will need to know. And your teacher should also provide you with a list. Now you're ready for the three examples, plus at the end I'll teach you a trick on how to memorize the polyatomic ions even faster. Example one, same charges. We are given the compound name of magnesium carbonate and asked to find the chemical formula. So let's first identify the symbol for magnesium and its charge. Magnesium has a charge of 2+. Next, we'll identify what carbonate is and its charge using our common polyatomic ion table. We'll see that carbonate is CO3 with a 2- charge. Since we have the same charges, there is no need for an additional subscript since our charges are already balanced. So this is our chemical formula. Going from the chemical formula to the compound name, we will identify the name of the metal and the name of the polyatomic ion. This is lithium and this is acetate. The compound name is then lithium acetate. Example two, different charges. Our given compound name is aluminum sulfate and we are finding the chemical formula. So identify the symbol and the charge of aluminum, which is Al with a 3+ charge, and sulfate is SO4 with a 2- charge. Since this is an ionic compound, we must balance the charges. To balance the charges, the charge of sulfate now becomes aluminum's new subscript, and the charge of aluminum now becomes the new subscript for sulfate. Note, whenever a polyatomic ion requires a subscript, we will place the entire polyatomic ion in parentheses with the added subscript outside of the parentheses. So this is our chemical formula. Now going from the chemical formula to the compound name, we will identify the name of the metal and the name of the polyatomic ion. Ca is calcium and OH is hydroxide. So our compound name is calcium hydroxide. Example three, both are polyatomic ions. Given the compound name of ammonium sulfate, we'll find the chemical formula by identifying each type of polyatomic ion and their charges. Ammonium is NH4 with a 1+ charge, and sulfate is SO4 with a 2- charge. To make the charges the same, the ammonium needs a 2 subscript, so ammonium will be in parentheses with a 2 subscript outside of the parentheses followed by SO4, and this is our chemical formula. Now going from the chemical formula to the compound name, we will identify each polyatomic ion's name. NH4 is ammonium and NO3 is nitrate. The compound name is then ammonium nitrate. Okay, here's the trick on how to remember all the polyatomic ions faster. Most polyatomic ions end in either ite or ate. Notice how the ones ending in 8 have one more oxygen than the ones ending in ite. There's the trick. The 8s have one more oxygen than the ites. Now you only have to remember the 8s, so this cuts your memorizing in half. This topic is so important. That's why I created several videos, And I designed a how-to guide on naming compounds and acids that includes over 30 pages of detailed examples and explanations, all to save you time and get it right the first time around. The link to shop my notes is in the description box, along with other helpful resources like homework help and tutoring and so much more. And remember, stay determined. You can do this.